Hi there. This video comes with some exercise files and a cheat sheet for Photoshop. There'll be a link in the description for those. Okay, it's part of my larger course, which you can go and check out. There'll be a link there as well. All right, enjoy the video. Hi there. This video, we are going to look at kind of bending and distorting and skewing. We're going to try and lay it down on the ground and then kind of morph it around the shoe here. So it looks like it's kind of following the curve. Let's do that now using Adobe Photoshop's transform tools. All right, let's open up the file we're going to be working with. File open, and we're working in the exercise files in this folder called 08 transform. Open the one called transform 01. Great, so we wanna mock up this logo on this. Let's look at the basics for transforming first, then we'll go and add the logo. So to bring in the image, I can open it, copy and paste it, which we've been doing for a lot of this course. I'm gonna show you another way. File, there's one that says place embedded. Okay, and go to that same folder and open up logo AI, click place. It's gonna put it in as a smart object automatically because it knows it's an AI file and it goes, your vector, you should be smart object. And we're totally down with smart objects now. All we need to do is give it a size and then hit return because it's kind of stuck in this kind of like limbo mode. Can you see none of these things work? So if I hold down shift, okay, and we can scale it down. Scale it down to something appropriate like that, hit enter. And what we're gonna do is we'll start with one copy just up here. We're gonna duplicate the logo, right click. Duplicate layer. This is going to be called logo 2, and we'll move it down. And let's look at the basics for transforming. Let's go to edit, transform, and we've dealt with scale before and rotate before. And some of the other easy ones that you might use is rotate clockwise, counterclockwise. We'll go back the other way. You can flip it 180, which flips it completely upside down. Another one in there you might use is flip horizontal and vertical. It's not gonna really work in this case. If I go horizontal, it's a backwards logo, but it's good to know where that's kept. I'm gonna undo. Now the next thing I wanna do is I wanna kind of bend it down the bottom here, like we saw in the intro on the floor. And under edit, transform, you can see a bunch of these are grayed out. Remember in the last video where we talked about smart objects and most things work with it, except for the very first thing we're gonna do in this course after we've learned, convert everything to a smart object. Because distort, perspective, and warp don't work. And those are the ones we want to learn. So remembering how to convert it from a smart object back to regular layer is right click logo and say, I would like you to be a rasterized layer. Nothing much changes except that little icon's gone and magically edit, transform, these things appear. Now I never use skew. I'll save you the trouble of testing it because it just does this. I'm not sure when you'd use that. Or at least I don't use it. So I'm gonna hit escape as the kind of I didn't mean it button, escape on my keyboard. But the ones that I do use, we're gonna use say distort first. I love this one. And it's really good for mocking up like signs that you've made onto real objects. So this one here, I'm just gonna kind of, I'm clicking anywhere but the center, moving it down here. And all you do is grab the corners and it's kind of like in this weird flat plane that you can start manipulating. Now it's not gonna match the background automatically. Okay, so there's a lot of just you having a look. I'm doing it right now by kind of got, I don't know why I close one eye when I'm doing it. Seems to help with my perspective. Does that look like it's on the ground? It's good enough. When I'm ready, hit enter. You could fake a sign for a billboard or say you've mocked up a cover of a magazine. You could have a picture of a magazine. Bring in your, say, InDesign cover ideas and mock it up using that distort. Now the next one I want is I'm gonna duplicate logo again. And we're gonna look at warp. So right clicking it. Duplicate layer, logo 3. Remember, right click it and say, you have to be a rasterized layer, sorry buddy. I'm gonna move it down to kind of roughly where I want it. I'm gonna get it down to a rough size. I'm using edit transform scale. Okay, yeah. Now we're gonna use the edit transform and we're gonna use this one called warp. I'm gonna zoom in a bit and show you how it works. It's a little weird. Okay, grab one of the corners, click hold and just give it a wiggle. Kind of turns it more like fabric. Whereas the last one made it like a block, made it like a sheet that you could kind of manipulate. Okay, this one here is a lot more, warp here is a lot more kind of elastic. Okay, it's more like a sheet of paper. So I can move it around. So there's two parts to it. There's these corners, they're called anchor points. Okay, so the edge of this image has to go to that anchor point wherever it is. These other little things here called handles are the way that the line gets influenced. Okay, you can see it doesn't, nothing actually has to pass through this little black dot, but it kind of like gravity, kind of like distorts the line before it hits the anchor point. So just know every anchor point here has two handles. There's a top one, okay, and the bottom one. And now it's the same principle again. There's a lot of just kind of like dragging it around, saying, okay, I feel like that's the bottom. I'm trying to get the perspective lining with the bottom of that shoe there. And then see these two little handles here? I'm just trying to distort it to make it feel like it was following the kind of path. Might have it up a little bit there. Type of these little weavy lines to follow, but same with this one here. You can see it kind of doubled back on itself, so I want it about there, but then I'm gonna have to adjust these lines. So a lot of messing around, just getting a feel for it. This bottom one here, it's a little hard to see some of these dots. I shouldn't have picked a stripy shoe. If you're practicing with me, you're cursing the stripy shoe. Probably cursing the shoe theme throughout this whole course. Hope you're not getting too bored of it, but I went with the shoe theme. Okay, so what am I doing now? I'm just kind of messing around trying to get it to flow. Now, can you see the lines in the center here are kind of a bit weird? You can actually just click and drag these as well, any of these points in here, because we've kind of fixed the outside. Now we just need to kind of drag the inside to make it feel like it was part of it. Good. It's okay. All right, I'm gonna stop there because you're just watching me do this. I could be at it for a while. Hit return when you're ready. Zoom out and you've got something kind of bent around the shape. I haven't done a great job. One of the things that make it super obvious is that the colors are just super strong and don't have any of this kind of, they're not interacting with the background very much. So we've looked at this before, remember blending modes? So on my logo 3, okay, it's this layer here, turn the eyeball on and off. Up where it says normal, remember we've played around with a few of these. We're gonna look at multiply and that kind of works. It's kind of cool and maybe a bit strong. So you just work your way through all these options to find one that you feel works good with your shoe and your image and your background color. I was playing around with this. What looked good? Linear light, I think it did. I kind of liked linear light. Changed the color quite a bit of my graphics, so maybe that's not what I want. Hard light. Maybe that's a bit closer. And I really want to go back and fix this because it doesn't look very realistic. Cool, so I hope you got an understanding of some of those transform tools. I don't use them all. Some of them are just a bit weird, like perspective. Just use distort, quicker and easier, in my opinion. Last little things I'll throw in at the end here are image, and sometimes image rotation. Instead of doing it per layer, you can do the whole thing. Remember we looked at rotating it clockwise, just the particular layer? This does the whole graphic. Same with flipping it. So if you want to flip this across, okay, the whole thing rather than just a particular layer. Plus there was rotate in there, image, image rotation, and there's a few little things in there to work with. And that's where they're hiding. All right, I will see you in the next video. Hi, it's me again. If you enjoyed the video, a thumbs up really helps me in what I'm doing. Also consider subscribing to my YouTube channel because I release a video like this every week. Also know that this is part of my larger course. Okay, so this is like a free part of it. There's a larger course called Photoshop Essentials. So you could go check that out. There's a link in the description for that full course. Also know that there's exercise files. Those are free to download. Go check that out, link in the description. Another link in the description will be the cheat sheet. So I make it like a PDF cheat sheet for Photoshop with all the tips and tricks you can print off and stick next to your computer and be more awesome. Link in the description. yeah, all right, that's enough. Hi, Dada.